Yeah, welcome to the channel with the coolest guys I know. They review movies and all that. Let me introduce you to the host. Got Rip Black, but he's the white guy. Zach White, and he's the black guy. Try not to get confused. Hit subscribe and stay tuned to the Black and White Reviews. Black and White Reviews. Ay, Black and White Reviews. Black and White Reviews. Yeah, with the coolest dudes. Come and join the crew. Yeah, this is Black and White Reviews. Black and White Reviews. Hey, subscribe to the channel.
Welcome, everyone. I'm Rick Black.
And I'm Zach White.
And this is Black and White Reviews.
Litmus test.
So this is what's going to happen. To kind of get a baseline, because this obviously being a new review channel, to kind of give you a baseline of how we review movies, Mr. Manchild's going to shout out 20-plus movies, and we're going to do a quick review of it, giving a rating and a one or two little, you know, thoughts or feelings on it. So, Mr. Manchild.
All right. John Wick.
Okay, I'll kick off with John Wick. So, John Wick, we'll do one and two, because you got to kind of group them together. The John Wick series. I'm not a big Keanu Reeves guy. When I first saw it, I didn't know how to feel about it, because it's a you know, kind of a badass movie. Mm-hmm. But I couldn't take Bill and Ted Excellent Adventures serious. So the first one I could care less about. And it took me like three sittings to get through it. So I'm going to give John Wick 1, I'm going to give a half black thumb. John Wick 2, I blew me away. I don't know why it made such a difference in my life, but John Wick 2, I'm going to give two black thumbs.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Whenever I see Keanu, I'm always thinking of Neo. So to see him in a different role, and you went back to Bill and Ted, I mean, I don't even know why you would even bring that up.
I mean, that's his most iconic role.
I don't know why you would bring that up.
His most iconic role. Whoa!
No, I mean, I like both movies, and I think they were about the same. I don't think 2 was exceptionally better than the first. In fact, I think I liked the first a little better.
Okay.
And but both movies with, I think I would give them both two man shots.
Two man shots. Okay. That's a high rating, folks, for Mr. White.
Yeah.
Mr. White, stingy on the man shots. Stingy.
All right, next 300.
300, man. You want to kick off?
300, that's got to be one of my favorite movies of all time. Just great. Gerard Butler was awesome. The I don't know what's going on here. I don't know what we're witnessing right here. I really don't. I don't know. He's having a friend, a Sanford and Son, John and Elizabeth in heaven.
I need some oxygen.
Yeah. Great movie. Loved the action. Loved everything about it. I really can't find anything to complain about.
Is this real?
With 300.
Is this real life?
This is real life.
I mean, because
this is real life.
I mean,
this is a 4.5 man shot for 300. The movie was
baby
amazing.
Jesus take me out. I mean,
which there are not to like about 300.
We agree, and I don't know. Yeah. I mean, Frank Miller did an amazing job. I think. I mean, we didn't talk Sin City or anything like that, but I think this is better. I thought was a beautiful shot movie. I love the story. I'm a sucker for, you know, especially, and I like when people die at the end. You're going to find that out about me. I don't know if it's the sadistic side of me, but I enjoy when the hero doesn't make it, and it's about the story. So, no, we don't like it probably for the same reasons, but I'm gonna give it two black thumbs. But I mean, I'm blown away and speechless. I mean, Mr. White, you stole my heart.
All right, the Harry Potter series.
If I could just skip to the last two movies, I probably would be okay with that. Just a little too kiddy in the beginning for me. But still, I mean, anything with Ralph Fiennes and Lord Voldemort was amazing. If I have to connect it all together, since that's what we're doing, I'm going to give it 3.5. three man shots.
I really thought you were gonna kind of pull back a man shot there, but I mean, it's like I don't even know you sometimes. I mean, overall, you know, when you transition a book to a movie, and this is gonna shock you, but I don't read a lot of books. I mean, I'm sure a lot of my black people out there don't read a lot of books at times, but I really I can't complain about any of the movies. I would give it two black thumbs easily. All
right, American History X.
I'll start this one. So you got a we're getting into a pretty serious drama.
Right.
I saw this movie. It was probably like 1920 when this movie came out. I'm a huge Edward Norton guy. I mean, we haven't really tapped into the Edward Norton love yet, but he by far one of my favorite actors, and the curb stomp scene was I don't grimace a lot, you know. I was like, ooh. And then just the overall storytelling in that movie, I loved it, man. That's a three black thumbs.
Yeah,
that was a top movie for me. That for a while, I had to have girls watch this movie, and if they didn't like it,
they were out. Yeah. Well, we're actually gonna agree on this one as well. I mean, this movie was iconic.
Mm-hmm.
As vicious as the curb stomp scene was, the shower scene.
Yeah.
With the Nazi or whatever. I mean, that was even.
Yeah.
That was right up there too. Great movie. I'm not as Eddie Norton. I don't care if I never see Eddie Norton.
Yeah, he knows him on that.
Yeah, I don't care if I ever.
He see knows him as
any of his
Eddie.
Movies again. I mean, he's always just gonna be.
And wrap it up. Right? You called him Eddie. You called him Eddie. It's unforgivable.
But for the movie. I'm going to give it three man shots.
Okay, three man shots.
Yeah.
For Eddie Norton, folks.
Eddie Norton.
Yeah. Okay.
The Lord of the Rings trilogy.
I mean, what is there to say? Let's just give it the five man shots and be done.
Okay. Well,
all right. That's it. Nothing else to say about it.
I mean, if you enjoy pointless nonsense, let's talk about that movie. I mean, first off, you can.
That's so different.
If you look at you, I don't know what order we're going to post videos, but we talked about The Rock, and you talked about you know what are those movies about, and then you go into The Lord of the Rings, and that was a bunch of hobbits walking and pointless storytelling. If it wasn't with the little guy going, you know, Precious, and that's probably the only thing I can remember. I mean, I don't even know the joke because I watched the movies. So I watched the movies twice over each one, and I, because I guess I'm a masochist, I just like putting myself through pain. I give that a negative.
Oh, my God.
I would actually, if someone was going to chop my black thumb off, I would chop my black thumb off. I mean, it's like either you want to watch. Nah, I'm good. Next one, man shot.
Fight Club.
Oh, man. Okay.
I mean, it's
so let me start this one off. Okay. Yeah. So I'm 17 years old. This movie's out on DVD back then, okay? This is aging me, I guess, right? So I'm in high school, right? I'm in with my high school sweetheart. We watched the movie at her house. Her dad had just purchased it on a DVD, which was a big deal back then, you know. And I watched this movie and I'm like, this is the greatest movie I've ever seen. Now, I've already started telling you a little bit about the Edward Norton love. Brad Pitt is amazing. And Brad Pitt's abs, on point. And after the movie, she looked at me and I go, that was a great movie. And she goes, that was a stupid movie. And I said, you're the stupid one. And that's into that. So I'm going to give that two of man shots thumbs, two black thumbs.
It was an okay movie. I mean, it wasn't It wasn't great. I mean, it wasn't horrible. Again, like I say, it was an Eddie Norton style movie where it's always going to be just average.
It's not the white guy trying to hold people back. I mean, that's just. I mean,
just for the sake of argument, I'll give it 2 man shots. But I mean,
I really don't. You're really generous with the white man shots.
I really don't.
You just hand out white votes.
I don't really care about it. What's next?
The Expendables trilogy.
Man. So, I mean, Stallone's known for many things, but he proved how big of a sucker we are. And he put together the weakest stories, and man, I'm just gullible. I said I ate it up. It's like an all-you-eat buffet. I was at Golden Corral, just going, "Oh, give me more Expendables!" Oh, I mean, they come in and the acting is 30-second little segments. Yeah, I mean, two black thumbs for that.
I mean, again, we're gonna have to agree on this one. The Expendables, it every guy that grew up, you know, the whole guys who like movies kind of thing with Stallone and Lundgren and all. It great movie, great series, loved it. I'm going to give that one 4 man shots.
Okay.
Yeah.
I am Legend.
I don't know if you watched our Bright video. We kind of had a conversation about Will Smith already.
I'm going to call him Willie Smith. Since we're just being loose with names on overrated actors.
I Am Legend was a great movie. Mm-hmm. It was a great movie, and the just you know you talk about beautifully made and all you know the dog dying in that movie I think was that was a piece of cinematic sadness of all time.
Him having not Bob dying.
The
mannequin.
Yeah, I mean,
how do you not know about Bob? He was the most iconic character.
We're having a beautiful moment talking about Sam the dog, and you want to talk about Bob?
Correct.
All right. Who cares about Bob? I Am Legend was a great movie. I saw on the internet there was like some alternate ending whatever. I don't really know if that's real or not.
Yeah, yeah. It's on the
kind of wish.
It's on the Blu-ray DVD.
No,
is it
real? I didn't
see a better ending.
It's a better ending. Mm-hmm. Great movie. Will Smith did a great job. I would definitely give that one 4 man shots. I loved I Am Legend.
Okay. I'm glad you brought up the dog. That's a great segue for me because I guess there's moments in your life that are defining. Mm-hmm. And when that dog died and, you know, it's his sanity right there, like that was the dog was representing what was left of his family in dying. And I could not stop laughing. That is the funniest moment. I mean, you talk about and you hear little kids crying in the background, and I couldn't stop. I had to get up and go to the bathroom because I couldn't stop chuckling. I mean, it's a good movie. The ending's, I'm glad there's an alternate ending, but I can ultimately not watch that again, so I'll give it 1 black thumb.
One.
Yeah, I mean, they had something there, but they lost it. And, I mean, there's parts of that movie where I go, that's a good movie. And then there's other parts I go,
American Beauty.
This one's tough. Because I enjoyed the movie. I don't know if I should have enjoyed it as much as I did.
Is that the Kevin Spacey factor?
Kevin Spacey was great in this movie. Okay. But I'm a Spacey guy.
Yeah.
All right. I mean, I would put him up against, you know, some of the, you know, your Eddie Norton and Rocks any days. But I'm a Spacey guy.
Minus the little boys. Minus little boys, folks. Well, he's not pro little boys. I'm not going to speak for Mr. White, but I'm fairly confident.
He's a great actor.
Okay, we're just talking about that. I diverge. I'm sorry. Sometimes
that part where he's. The restaurant scene when he's applying for the job, he's got his resume. He says, "Look, I have experience." I mean, that great movie. I'm gonna give it 3 man shots.
Okay. It's a good movie. I mean, I don't know if it's Kevin Spacey's best work, but there's a lot to that movie. You need to watch that movie multiple times to really appreciate the detail that goes in that movie. I give it 2 black thumbs. I'm not going to be too controversial about it.
I think Kevin Spacey in House of Cards is a better. I think he did a better job as that character. But no, he's believable, and in that midlife crisis and all that, that's good stuff.
Fast and the Furious franchise.
I don't care about it. I really don't. Yeah. I don't give a damn about Fast and the Furious. Whatever.
It's the greatest.
Whatever.
Numerical. Sequeled movie of all times.
It may be. I don't have an opinion about it.
Yeah, well,
I don't really watch him.
I mean, but you don't appreciate the story arc. You they went from stealing DVDs and Manshaw predicts the moon. He thinks they're going to save the world by going to the moon. But just the story arc. I mean, you understand that now the world can only be saved by a bunch of street drivers. I mean, and Brian's been dead for two movies, and they don't even talk. I mean, that's standing ovation. That's storytelling, my friend. That's storytelling. I mean, I'm gonna give that two black.
It gets one man shot.
Okay. Titanic.
Well, listen, that movie was. I was probably 15 or 16 when I saw that movie. I think I saw it on pay-per-view. There's two very iconic scenes in that that'll never be forgotten in storytelling history. Obviously, at the front of the boat,
but
when he draws her, that probably got me through a tough teenage time. You know, it was a few cold showers and a cleanup. You know, I don't want to imply anything there, but I mean, that's a good movie. I mean, I don't want to say it's my favorite, and I've rewatched it. I don't know how it's held up over the years, but it's a classic. And it's a really well done movie, and the Rick and Morty tribute is one of my favorite episodes. So,
I'm not an in the closet Young and the Restless fan.
Okay,
I love the Young and the Restless. Vic Newman, Eric Braeden's one of my guys. He had a little small piece in that movie. If that wasn't in that movie, I could have probably blew my brains out trying to watch Titanic. That movie, I just was glad that it was over. I just was dating someone, she wanted to see it. I don't give a damn about Titanic. It gets one man shot.
Okay. Yeah. Man, it's a classic. I give it 1.5 black thumbs.
Pulp Fiction.
Classic. I mean, it's Tarantino, it's Samuel Jackson, John Travolta. I mean, how can anyone have any problem with that movie?
Yeah, I'm not, there's a lot of fights I like to pick with you, but I'm not going to go there.
That gets the five-star treatment.
Inception.
Titans and
Inception. Yeah, weird movie. It was kind of like if you watched our other review, we did a beer review. It's just one of those things that you had it, mm-hmm. and you're like, what the? I don't know enough. I
guess the problem is your white view is kind of shallow. I mean, because that movie is very deep. And I mean, it may be just maybe your wife view shallow on that. I mean, I'm not going to speak for you on that, but I would say it's a little shallow. I would definitely give that. That's a great movie.
A great movie.
That's two black thumbs easily.
No,
I mean, and I don't even want to talk about my other favorite actor, Leonardo DiCaprio. Right.
Excuse me, DiCaprio.
I know. Okay. Sometimes expressing the black opinion, I stutter. You know.
Watchmen. It gets two man shots.
Right. Watchmen.
Oh, The Watchmen. The comedian carried that movie. I could have done a little less black or Blue Dong. I'm sorry, I saw too much Blue Dong for my taste. I mean, there's just too much Blue Dong. I mean, when I think of that movie, I think the comedian was amazing. I like The Watchmen. I would give it three black thumbs, but then there's a Blue Dong there that knocks one of those thumbs right off. So I can only give it two black thumbs.
That has to be probably one of my all-time greatest disappointments in movies.
Oh, wow.
The soundtrack was great.
The soundtrack was great.
The movie itself, I was severely disappointed with The Watchmen.
Wow.
Real quick, what
was the biggest disappointment of them?
It just, the story. It wasn't good. The storytelling, the acting was.
I wish we had.
It's gonna get a man shot.
Where's the
one man shot?
Avatar.
Just a groundbreaking, transcending movie. It set the bar, and it took movies to new levels, especially in the 3D universe. It gets a 5-man shot from me. Okay. Loved it. I'm a Sigourney Weaver fan, so whatever she's in, I'm gonna like it. Okay. Doesn't really matter what it is.
Okay.
I feel like Avatar hate about to come, so I may have to get up in a minute.
Just brace yourself, because cinematically, it's probably the most gorgeous movie in history. I mean, visually. If I could just mute that movie and just watch it and just see the pictures and play the radio in the background, I guess that would vastly improve that movie. And you're getting 10 avatars coming. They're shooting them all at once because no one wants to see that shit. I mean, no one wants to see that series. I mean, you know, because whatever reason, I don't. I mean, when are they going to be out, man? Shot in 2020.
2022.
Yeah, I mean,
2024.
I'm hoping that. North Korea blows up that movie. Visually I'll give it 2 black thumbs, but the rest of the movie I'm gonna give it a half black thumb.
Transformers series.
The series? We're gonna do the series. You know, when I watched the first movie, the first time seeing Optimus roll up and transform, and you could even kind of hear the old transforming sound that the cartoon had, and hear, you know, his voice for the Prime's voice for the first time. I mean, I probably pissed my pants in the theater watching that movie. And then after I saw that, everything else is forgettable. This and the last movie. I mean, I don't even know what to say about it. You talk about a disappointing friend. Michael Bay should be arrested for what he did to that movie, to that series.
Mr. White.
Michael Bay.
Roll out with one black thumb.
It's one man shot. It's horrible.
Spider-Man Homecoming.
I'll go there. I'll start with this one. The only problem with this movie is that it came out this year and the year of comic book movies. Mm-hmm. Because if this came out, last year, did Civil War come out last year? Or 2016?
Yeah.
Okay, I mean, it would, if it wasn't around this Marvel Universe, if it was a standalone Spider-Man movie, it'd be the greatest movie, superhero movie of that year. But the problem is it came out this year. And there's been too many movies that have done an amazing job, but there's no complaints. I mean, if you have, they took a teen drama, mm-hmm. and made it into a superhero film, and God bless Marvel. You know, they can save anything. I mean, thank God they own Fox's X-Men. I mean, that's gonna, we'll get into that till a later date, but I'm gonna give it, it's 2 black thumbs easily for me.
And I'll give it 3 man shots. It wasn't a horrible movie. I mean, mm-hmm. it wasn't my favorite Spider-Man movie by far. But anytime we can get a Marvel movie and a Spider-Man movie, it's at least worth,
Man Shot, what do you feel about Homecoming?
It was okay. Yeah. I wasn't. It could have. He was a great Spider-Man.
Okay.
He was a great.
Enough of you.
He could have been better.
Yeah, we'll edit that out first. Don't worry. I mean, you don't have to hear that nonsense. He's just behind the camera. I mean,
Gladiator.
I'll start off with Gladiator. I had a PS2, and the biggest attribute to the PS2 was a DVD. Mm-hmm. And the first DVD I bought, Gladiator. Russell Crowe's only performance that's mattered. But it's a great movie. If you don't like it, you don't just walk away now. Just walk away from life. I mean, you should be watching movies. I mean, there's nothing bad about that movie. Are you not entertained? Is one of my favorite lines of all time.
Like
2 black thumbs.
Like 300. I mean, if you don't like Gladiator,
this channel's not for you.
Something's wrong with you. You need to. And don't leave any comment about Gladiator sucked or anything like that. It's if you don't like that movie, do something with yourself.
Dusk Till Dawn.
Oh, I love Dusk Till Dawn. That movie was such. Juliette Lewis. I'm a Juliette Lewis fan.
Okay.
All right. And I love Juliette Lewis. And I really, I didn't know too much about George Clooney when I first saw the movie. Mm-hmm. And then that movie made me a Clooney fan. And I love vampire movies to begin with. That movie was, I can't find one complaint about that movie. That movie was amazing.
I mean, I'm not I'm not as up on the movie as you, but yeah, I'm okay with it. It's 1.5 black.
Yeah, that movie, I'm gonna give that 4.5. It just was a great movie.
Fifth Element.
I'll kick off because I'm probably the minority in this. I mean, I don't want to go say that too many times, but the reality is that movie is very overrated. I mean, I know it's a sci-fi movie. Bruce Willis is okay. If she doesn't wear that white outfit, that white stripe thing, a lot of you boys would not even care about that movie. I'll give it a half a black.
Even film. With it, I didn't care about the movie.
Oh, you did? Yeah, that shocked.
Fifth Element, just because it's sci-fi doesn't make it.
Well, I mean, sometimes sci-fi gets passed with bad stories when you put in that category.
It was an okay movie. I really have no opinion about it.
Rating?
I'd give it probably a one man shot.
Okay.
Yeah.
Man shot. How do you feel about it?
I love Fifth Element.
Yeah,
I loved
good.
It. That was great.
When you're gonna go watch the remastered Fifth Element, we're gonna go see Homecoming. So,
I loved it. Braveheart.
I recently just watched Braveheart again because needed some inspiration in life, and by far, one of the best movies in my generation. It changed me. I mean,
it changed.
It did. I mean, there's, you know, I'm a stubborn person, and that last scene when all he's got to do is just submit to the king and freedom, over the top freedom. I'm speechless, man. I love that movie. If you really want to be part of my group, being a black person, you have to love that movie. I mean, you really do. I mean, Mr. White?
I don't... It's one of my favorite Mel Gibson movies. It's one of probably top three Mel Gibson movies. I love Braveheart. Again, that, like you said, the end scene was amazing. There's nothing really to debate on that one. I think we both agree Braveheart was...
You good on that, man, Chuck?
I'm good on that.
Okay. We got a three.
I'm giving that 4.
I mean, that's a three black folks. Yeah, I mean, right.
The Matrix.
The Matrix.
Yeah. I'll kick off Matrix. So.
I have a bad feeling about this.
Yeah, I mean, if you should sit for this.
All right.
Okay, so Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventures is going to lead this Superman Jesus story or whatever this is. Whatever what were the brothers called?
The Warrens.
It doesn't matter. They're forgettable. I mean, have they made anything since Superman Returns or whatever? They made that, right?
No.
Oh, I thought
Speed Racer.
Oh, Speed Racer. Speed Racer. That iconic remake movie. Matrix 2 is a very action-packed movie. If you separate that movie, you can go in there. But the acting's terrible. The story is god-awful, atrocious. I mean... what was the agent's name?
Agent Smith?
Yeah. Exactly.
What was his name? I mean, what do you mean, what was his name?
I mean, I don't rewatch that crappy movie. I mean...
The first Matrix?
Yeah, whatever. It's all...
I could see the second two. The first one?
Wait, which... Okay.
I had to rate them, I mean, it's two... At least two's got some action in it. It makes it a little bit more tolerable than the story. I mean, Keanu Reeves' acting is a limited scale. I mean, after Speed, did he really make anything until John Wick? I mean, but that you could debate that with yourself. You can go in the closet or something.
Did you see Hardball? Was a good movie.
I want to ruin that movie. Spoiler alert, yeah. The little black kid dies. Yeah. There was a group of girls watching this movie, and I was fighting with a girlfriend of mine, and I walked in there and said, "Hey," and they were right at the beginning, and I said, "Hey, the little black kid dies," and then they looked at me like I just told them Santa doesn't exist, and very awkward moment in my life, because I was doing that to be spiteful, but I'm not going to be spiteful here. I'm just going to tell you, Matrix as a trilogy is terrible. I'm not even giving it any thumb.
I mean, that's bad. I don't even know what to say to that. The Matrix trilogy was amazing.
Amazing.
From the first two to the last movie. I mean, all those characters from Trinity, Neo, Morpheus. I mean, you name it, they're all iconic, legendary. I don't know what's your problem with it. Like, you never really say it. What issue you?
Well, the story really was terrible. The story was mediocre.
So the fight scenes weren't good.
Yeah, whatever. Yes.
You know, I saw
the crane.
That was the first movie I saw in IMAX. Actually, I saw it at the aquarium when they still had their IMAX thing. And I mean, I walked in there. I think it was part two actually, and I was just blown away by that movie. And his name's Agent Smith, by the way.
Yeah,
Agent Smith. And you didn't like Lord of the Rings either, so you must have something against Lord Elrond. What's his name? The Major Agent Smith and Hugo Weaving.
Sorry.
You must have something against
Hugo Weaving. I do have.
You gave a zero to Lord of the Rings, right. And you gave a zero to
and
Major
Transformers.
Smith. So right, and Transformers. Yeah. So you're anti Hugo Weaving. We just figured that out. So
I don't know if it's so much that or just bad acting.
That's Hugo Weaving.
Okay.
All right.
If you want to say Hugo Weaving, tomato, tomato, bad acting.
Right.
I mean,
You can't. You know, the Hugo Weaving hate is
it's gone too far.
Right. You went over the line with the Matrix.
Well, I don't.
And Bill and Ted and everything else. This gets five man shots.
Yeah. Okay. Well, right. There you go, folks. Wow. Five man shots for that movie trilogy.
Django Chain,
you know, Quentin Tarantino. There is no bad Quentin Tarantino movie.
No.
And Django and Chain, I know the only thing that has ever got criticized is what, using the N-word? That it? That's the only thing ever bad about that, was people were upset. And then it also has one of my favorite actors, obviously. I'm not going to say Jamie Foxx.
No.
Don't get excited.
Oh, it has your, DiCaprio?
Yeah, Leonardo.
Yeah. Okay.
The man.
Right.
I mean, Mandingo.
Yeah,
I pay him $5 to just say Mandingo.
If you're gonna ask anything about Tarantino, you're gonna get at least three man shots just from it being a Tarantino flick. But with Django, I give that four man shots.
Okay,
yeah.
That is that. Right. Okay, so that is the Lippman test. Any final thoughts? I mean, we now this is the first time we've really talked about a lot of movies at once. Right. Anything shock you or anything surprising?
I think the Hugo Weaving hate was the biggest shock.
Yeah.
For you to not like any Hugo Weaving movie.
Yeah, that's a...
You didn't like Megatron.
I mean, we needed...
You didn't like Agent Smith. You don't like Lord Elrond. You didn't like anything he's done. So, I mean, taken away, I think the love you have for Fight Club and the hate you have for Hugo, I think that's a big... That's big. That's big.
I would say what shocks me with you is, I guess that, you know, when I talk, I always keep saying great storytelling, you can't predict it. I mean, you're a great story because I can't predict you. I mean, you're shocking. You're the most confusing, Mr. White, you're the most confusing white I've ever really have ever had the, I guess, I want to say pleasure and displeasure of talking to you.
Right.
I mean, because sometimes my heart just... Like, you built me up early, you made me fall in love with you, and then you let me back down, and just something else. But I think that's it. Any closing thoughts from you, Mr. Manshot?
No, I was surprised about The Matrix. That really,
Matrix,
that's
going to be the divider.
Yeah, right? That was a hot part.
All right, let's throw it out to the fans, okay? Do you agree with Mr. White in the internal love of a very mediocre trilogy, or are you a black guy?
And the white vote is going to come out in mass on this one. This is going to be a blowout. This is a landslide. This is 49 states.
Listen, here's the thing.
You have no chance of this one.
You may win the Electoral College on this one. I've spanked you enough times. You may come up. This may be your little, like, give you a little hope that, you know, this might be a new hope, you know. Star Wars pun for you. All right. Well, for Mr. Black, see you guys next time.
Mr. Black.
I'm for Mr. Black.
You for Mr. Black?
All right. I'm done. You can close this up.
All right. Well, again, leave your comments. Let us know what y'all think about our reviews. Again, just don't even entertain. If you're going to leave Matrix hate, just please be prepared. The white vote will come after you on this one.
Will it?
We're gonna come after people on this one.
Okay.
If there's Matrix hate out there in the comments, we're gonna.
I really need the black people to rally on this.
You need them to come out because we're gonna fight for this one, and that's all I have to say.
Okay.
All right.
Until next time.
Until next.
Yeah, welcome to the channel with the coolest guys I know. They review movies and all that. Let me introduce you to the host. Got Rip Black, but he's the white guy. Zach White, and he's the black guy. Try not to get confused. Hit subscribe and stay tuned to the Black and White Reviews. Black and White Reviews. Ay.